for 16, 17 years. I was married for about 13 years in Kalinga, had 5 kids, and I thought I'd worked my young adult life to be in my final home, I thought, and the very next day I found out I wasn't in a marriage anymore, so that was a surprise to me and to my children. And so my son Justin became very angry, and we noticed that, I don't know, we didn't want to go to our church anymore. We just stayed home, and then Justin started coming home from school and telling us about this lady Mary had met, and she was telling him things on the car rides back and forth to football practice, and we saw the joy in him return, so we'd asked, well, what did she say this time? And he was sharing those things with us, and then he said he really wanted to go to a meeting. So we went to a meeting where we were told we could receive the Spirit, and I thought, oh no, it's a Pentecostal church. And but everything was in order, and my son received the Spirit the first time. We sat down to pray, and he was very excited about it, and so I prayed and asked the Lord to show me if it was just a gift for Justin or if it was for my whole family. And I received the Spirit, then I knew that this was the missing piece to me going to all these churches. And I'd also done the thing where they tell you accept Christ as your Savior, and that's nowhere in Scripture. And so when I received the Spirit, I knew that's the missing piece that I needed all along. And I didn't even realize all the things I'd been healed from mentally. And I never wanted to live in Fresno. I didn't like Fresno. And when we were going to church here and stuff, we went looking at houses because I couldn't keep traveling back and forth. And so we found a house, and then I remember we were at a gathering where all the saints were, and Carlton said, well, did you get the house? Because I was on the phone with the realtor, and I said yes, but I didn't look excited, and he said, praise the Lord, and I said yes, and he said, what's the matter? I said, I don't know if I'm supposed to do this, and he said, you know what your problem is? And I said, I don't know what I wanted to know, like, am I supposed to do this? And he said, God's trying to bless you, and you won't accept God's blessing. And I thought, yeah, I'm not letting God bless the situation and go with it. This is what I've been praying about missing all the time. So last time I gave my testimony, it was really hard for me to remember people's names and stuff. And I gave this testimony to my daughter, and she said, that's the testimony you should give. And because I shared that with her, because she came home from school, and she was upset at the situation with the kids at school. And I said, well, we'll pray, and God can either change the situation at school, or he can change our situation. And the next week, they put our house up for sale. And that's, I remember praying, like, Lord, that's not what I meant. But we were looking at being homeless, and I remember going to the prayer line, and a brother prayed for us to have a better home than the one we were in. And I just remember the prayer made me smile because it gave us hope, but I never wanted a better home. I just wanted a home. And the Lord's blessed us with that better home than the one we were in. And we prayed for the children, too, in the neighborhood with my daughter. And that's, I guess, the testimony I want to give. We prayed for our home situation and for her to have friends. And so on the block where we moved, there is probably, I don't know, 5 or 6 kids, and they're all just genuinely nice kids. Like, I heard they were really quiet outside. I opened the door, and one of the kids is reading scripture, and I thought, he's reading from the Bible. He's reading to all the kids. And I asked him, oh, you're reading from Scripture? And he said, yeah, I think I want to be a pastor. So we've been able to talk to all these kids about the Lord. And even last night, we were talking about the Lord. Allison, Pastor Dave came. We figured out they had played with Jane's kids before when they lived in our house. And so I just see where the Lord blesses us when we feel like we don't deserve it, and how they're good blessings, but, you know, there's hard lessons in life too. And if we lean on the Lord and let Him bless us, He'll do that.